take a step back. Cause it's Elie Seckbach. And when my dad, I didn't tell him what I did. I just found him working like in a neighborhood,
yeah,
cutting grass.
Right, okay.
And I told him, hey, can you come cut my grass? And so he came over, whatever. He started working for me a couple of weeks. One day, my dad comes to my house, but he didn't know that was my dad.
Yeah.
So my dad's knocking on the door, and he says, "Who you guys looking for?" He says, "Oh, Mike." He says, "Hey, be careful. I don't know what that guy does. He's real young, but he doesn't even work, and he just drives nice cars, and I don't know what he's up
to." He thought you were doing something highly illegal.
And so my dad says, "Oh, that's my son. He's a boxer." He says, "Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know. I had no idea. I didn't know."
He's not all there, though. He's a funny guy, bro.
He's a funny guy. But when I met him, you know, he was working for other homes.
Yeah, now he just works for you?
Now he's just working for me.
No, I've seen him in the videos. He's pretty funny.
Yeah, a couple years ago, he was working, you know, and for me, but then he started getting caught up too much alcohol, and he did some time, but he came to the airport
yesterday, and he picked you up.
He got out last year, like in June, July, and I had him start working on my ranch again, so now he's living up there. So
that's badass. It's very nice of you to help him.
He's happy.
I'm gonna have to get up to the ranch and get some oranges.
I don't think we have any right now.
We're all over the place.
Not at the ranch.
Alright, we're gonna shoot.
Yeah, we can do that.
Shooting is easy.
We can do that.
Oh, it's sitting in the Lambo.
How do you know Cruz, the MMA fighter?
It's metal right now.
Oh.
Through Ed.
Yeah, Ed told me he was on a podcast. Your podcast with Ed blew up, did very well.
Yeah, we did a podcast with him, a show, and I met Ed, and we did that podcast. And we kept in touch, and we became, friends, and he asked if I would allow him to bring Dominick. I said, yeah, hell yeah.
I want to say he fought someone big. Who did Dominick Cruz fight from the big names?
He fought a good amount. He beat Demetrius Johnson.
Mouse. He beat when the last fight?
Yeah, no. Like 2011.
Okay.
Yeah, Mighty Mouse. He fought Cody. He lost to Cody Garbrandt, but I mean that's still a big name.
Yeah, he has one loss.
He has a lot of kids. So Dominick, you're visiting Mikey today. Why'd you come visit him?
Here to learn, man. That's what I do. I'm a professional watcher.
Well, he's fighting Spence. March 16, major fight. Spence, the biggest, best, most avoided guy in boxing. And Mikey's a four-division champ moving up 2 weight classes.
Doesn't surprise me. It doesn't surprise me he's a champion. It doesn't surprise me that he's fighting the most dodged person in fighting, right? None of that surprised me. Just excited to see what that means. Like, when he spars, like, what you figure that out when you watch somebody train, why that is, what's making the difference, because you don't separate yourself to being different unless you're doing different things.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm interested, that's why I'm here.
Right now, who are your favorite MMA fighters to watch? Do you have any that you enjoy watching?
Yeah, I love watching Alexander Gustafsson, John Jones.
Yeah, they just fought John won, and now John has another fight in March.
Yeah, I mean, the list goes on. I mean, I watch so many fighters because that's my job too. I love watch. I'm a big fan of fighting. I'm a big fan of martial arts.
Nate Diaz,
well.
Nick Diaz.
Yeah, of course.
I can't wait for them to fight.
Those guys are awesome.
Good
I don't
people.
Know what Nick's doing. Nick's living the good life right now. Nate should be coming back soon. Gilbert Melendez too. I work for him. I love Gilbert.
Nate just worked the corner of a real kid. He just won this weekend. Yeah. Krause's a good dude too.
Yep.
Krause's is that Culver City over there?
Ice cream. Krone. That's what they call him. Krone. But got another Gracie in the sport now. The MMA back. New era. So that's cool. Everybody's happy about that because jiu-jitsu was part of MMA for so long.
Well, Dominick, Pita here. That's Mikey's nephew. Huge MMA fan.
Sick.
Was so excited to see Cain Velasquez. Was tweeting it, posting it. 20 seconds later.
Man, I was calling that fight, and I was excited. So I was like, and then at 20, it was just disappointed that I didn't get to see him fight. Because, like, Cain, I know Cain was disappointed.
and you're like, can we just run it back real quick? Just
an ASU guy.
Yeah,
guy.
I just want to run it back so bad, but that's why the sport's crazy.
But you know who's come to the gym a lot? Because his cousin trains here and fights here. Pantera Rodriguez, yeah, here.
Oh,
what a sick knockout he had. How does that even work? I mean, do you throw it hoping it will
honest
land?
Honest to God, he does tricky stuff. So you could say like...
He had to practice that.
He had to.
I'll say this.
You could say it was a fluke, yes. But I say it was being like in the now, in the moment, and being reactionary.
Being able to react to it. You had to have
done it. It was, it was a reaction like...
That's crazy.
If you practice on pads, going down faking to the body, and then like this on pads, when you're in the scenario, you might just pop it up there. So there's a possibility that this was a natural reaction read his body had, and I'm not going to hate on that.
Hey, that was a crazy knockout, though.
Yeah, that was sick.
Okay, there's a lot of mixture of boxing and MMA. We saw Mayweather McGregor. Khabib was talking about boxing. If you could fight one pro boxer, who would it be?
We all know it would be the boxer that can make the most money when you fight.
Floyd,
like
Money, Mayweather. Would you beat him in boxing?
In boxing? No.
In MMA, though, different story.
We already know. Come on. We all know.
You can fight 135. You can fight Lomachenko.
You and Loma?
You know, Lomachenko's quality. That man is quality. I actually study his boxing for MMA. He's got the perfect crossover style. If you're going to watch any boxer right now,
are you a southpaw too?
Go from boxing to southpaw. I switch.
Oh, just switch off.
Yeah, but if you're going to go from like straight boxing to MMA,
yes.
That's the style.
His footwork is sick.
Because of the footwork, and you don't have to worry about takedowns as much.
Yeah.
Whereas like right here, for a lot of specialists in boxing, takedowns are there, kicks are there. He's just moving enough that it might not be as bad. It might not take as much damage if you were to cross over to MMA. So I watch him. Yeah, he's good.
TJ sparred with him a little bit.
Yep.
Very little.
Yeah.
Dude, that was hard on him.
Yeah, but it wasn't.
Yeah.
It was like me sparring right now. It's a different sport.
I didn't check it.
It is. It's a different levels.
I was there.
You got a specialist, and that's all.
That's true.
That's on the picture.
Yeah.
You know, the days that you guys are in here hitting the bag, hitting the speed bag, focusing on accuracy and timing, we're wrestling, focusing on ways to choke people.
Yeah.
So, like, our hours are spent differently.
It's like different tendencies and stuff like that.
You know, Aldo trained here.
Aldo's awesome.
Now, he could choke, not you.
Picture.
Yeah, he was beating us up for fun, like choke us out in three seconds to do three different moves. Hand, arm bar,
yeah.
Kicks.
I mean, he's a nasty black belt too, so you gotta watch out for him.
By the way,
I've been fighting with Aldo forever. I'll always be a fan of him.
Too bad your shoulders hurt, though, I would say.
I know, I would love to. I'll be back, though, healthy.
He's injured today, but if he wasn't injured, he would spar you today.
Yeah, shoulder, right?
Yeah, shoulder. My right one. Yeah.
No, I'm saying that, not him.
You got what, 12 rounds? You do it a time?
Yeah, today we're doing 10.
A couple here and there would be sick. We get good. I would love to train with you. It would be an honor. I would love to, man. You guys are winning.
Nasty. What would you fight?
So I'm here to watch and learn today.
You fight at 35?
Yeah.
He's 135? Tall. Yeah, look at that.
Big bang, huh?
But what do you walk around? 180? 170?
No. 60.
He walks around a city. Yes, he loses 25
you
pounds.
You fight at 135?
Yeah. I have to.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah. I cut a lot of weight.
You do. You guys cut a lot of weight.
Yeah,
like wrestling.
Grew up wrestling.
You're a wrestler.
I started boxing at 19.
Yeah, you guys cut a lot of weight. And he's from Arizona. Huh? Yeah, he's from Tucson.
So wait, if you get in a street fight, do you use boxing or MMA?
Somebody goes, he takes them down in a street fight.
Yeah, I don't want to break my hands, and you don't want to leave marks because then you catch a case. So you keep them, set them down nicely. Everything's quiet. No marks.
No evidence.
Somebody smart, street smart, that was also a professional fighter. I'll tell you guys later who told me. But told me one day, look, you know we've been a family that always gets into fights, trouble, stuff like that. Never hit somebody with your fist in their face. Because you could really hurt somebody. Go to the body. Boom. Pop the body. You're not going to kill nobody. You're not going to kill them. You're not going to hurt them.
That's old OG wisdom.
You know, they could fall and they could die.
When they come down.
Yeah, they could die.
You give them a chance.
Just give them a body shot. That's all they need.
Right? Yeah. You hit them in their body. There's no being tough.
No? You beat Mighty Mouse, right?
Huh?
You beat Mighty Mouse. You beat him.
I did.
He beat the guy that was considered the best pound for pound MMA fighter in the world.
You know what's funny?
I was ranked number 2 on the pound for pound list behind him after I had beaten him.
How does that happen? Yeah,
wow.
Mighty Mouse. Oh. He beat the number one Papa Pombo, was ranked behind him. How does that work?
On the number two. He was one, I was number two.
Mighty Mouse.
And I beat him.
We saw Mighty Mouse's fight.
You tell me what that means. I don't know.
And then he grabbed him.
Yeah, that was crazy where he threw him up and he grabbed him.
Yeah, that was bad.
But MMA is weird like that.
It's hard.
It's hard?
It's a tough sport.
So is boxing. It is cool. But yeah, no, it's cool. Tell everybody where to follow you, Dominick, if they're watching. What is it?
DominickCruz.com.
Instagram.
Unlocking Victory with ESPN. My Instagram is Dominick Cruz, DomCruz619. All that stuff. Check
all right, make
out.
Sure to follow him. Stay tuned. Facebook.com. Check back. Reporting. Hold on. Fine.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. Thanks so much for tuning in. ES News, your source for your boxing news. I'm Elie Seckbach. Reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.
Ain't doing much, take a step back, cause it's Elie Seckbach. Reporting.